Students, we have been given a problem. Solve x square minus yz into p plus y square minus zx into q is equal to z square minus xy. And looking into the equation, you can easily understand that it is Lagrange's type of equation. That is capital P into P plus capital Q into Q plus capital P into P plus capital Q into Q is equal to R. Here you can fix P is equal to x square minus yz, Q is equal to y square minus zx, and R is equal to z square minus xy. Once you have fixed the given equation of the type Lagrange's type, you have to write the auxiliary equation. Now the auxiliary equation is dx by capital P is equal to dy by capital Q is equal to dz by capital R. Now let you substitute the values of P, Q and R. That is dx by x square minus yz is equal to dy by y square minus zx is equal to dz by z square minus xy. Here we can't make L into P plus M into Q plus N into R is equal to 0 by selecting any multipliers. You have to look into the equation deeply and you have to analyze whether you will be able to make L into P plus M into Q plus N into R is equal to 0 or not. Definitely it is not possible in our case. And also we cannot solve this problem using method of grouping also. Therefore, we have to go for a different approach. Let you identify the multipliers L, M, N and L dash, M dash, N, N dash, L dash, M dash, N dash such that equation number 1, L dx plus M dy plus N dz divided by L into P plus M into Q plus N into R is equal to equation number 2, L dash into dx plus M dash into dy plus N dash into dz divided by L dash into P plus M dash into Q plus N dash into R is equal to K. Now you have to understand this step very clearly. We are not able to make L into P plus M into Q plus N into R is equal to 0 by selecting any multipliers, and we cannot solve the problem using method of grouping also, so that we are going for a different approach as explained earlier. Let L is equal to X, M is equal to Y, N is equal to Z, and L dash is equal to 1, M dash is equal to 1, N dash is equal to 1. Now for L equal to X, for M equal to Y, for N equal to Z, let you form the equation number 1. It is X into dx plus Y into dy plus Z into dz. Divided by x into x square minus yz plus y into y square minus zx plus z into z square minus xy. And let this be equation be reduced to, let this equation be reduced to x into dx plus y into dy plus z into dz. Now you look into the denominator, you multiply by x in the first term, it is x cube, and in the second term it is y cube, and in the third term it is z cube. So x cube plus y cube plus z cube has been written. And in the first term you can find minus x y z by multiplication, and in the second term also you can find minus x y z by multiplication, and in the third term also you can find minus x y z by multiplication. So it is written as minus 3xyz. Now let you rearrange this equation, because we have to arrive at a solution and you have to know some algebraic formula also. Now x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz can be written as x plus y plus z into x squared plus y squared plus z squared minus xy minus yz minus zx. This formula you have to remember. Now, to construct the equation number 2, you look into the equation number 2. It is L dash into dx plus M dash into dy plus N dash into dz divided by L dash into P plus M dash into Q plus N dash into R is equal to K. So, to construct this equation, you are selecting the multipliers as L dash is equal to 1, M dash is equal to 1 and N dash is equal to 1. And you can get in the denominator L dash into dx, 1 into dx, it is dx. M dash into dy, 1 into dy is dy. N dash into dz, 1 into dz is dz. And in the denominator, you are multiplying P by 1, M by 1 and N by 1. P by 1 and Q by 1 and R by 1. And you look into the equation, the auxiliary equation. So they divide by 1. Each term is multiplied by 1. So it will become, you look into the first term of term 1, term 2 and term 3. It is x squared plus y squared plus z squared. When it is multiplied by 1, the other terms will become minus xy minus yz minus zx. Let this be equation number 2. Now, as per our discussion, we have to make 1 equal to 2. So, we have rewritten the equation as x into dx plus y into dy plus z into dz plus z into dz. X into dx plus y into dy plus z into dz divided by x plus y plus z into x squared plus y squared plus z squared minus xy minus yz minus zx. And the equation number 2 has also been rewritten here as dx plus dy plus dz divided by x squared plus y squared plus z squared minus xy minus yz minus zx. You look into the equation number 1 and equation number 2 at the denominators, so the second term are identical, so they get cancelled each other. So the remaining terms can be written as x into dx plus y into dy plus z into dz divided by x plus y plus z is equal to dx plus dy plus dz divided by 1. Now cross multiplying, you get x into dx plus y into dy plus z into dz is equal to the term in the denominator at the left hand side is moved to the right hand side. It will become x plus y plus z into d of, because dx plus dy plus dz can be written as d of x plus y plus z. Now taking integral for all the terms, it will become integration of x into dx plus integration of y into dy plus integration of z into dz is equal to integration of x plus y plus z into d of x plus y plus z. Now, the integration of x dx is x squared by 2. The integration of y dy is y squared by 2. The integration of z dz is z squared by 2. At the right hand side, you have to take the term x plus y plus z as a single identity. Therefore, so integrating x plus y plus z with respect to x plus y plus z, it is x power n model. So x plus y plus z the whole square divided by 2. The next term is c1 by 2 is the constant of integration. Now all the terms are having 2s and they can be cancelled. Now the equation become x squared plus y squared plus z squared is equal to is equal to, now you have to expand x plus y plus z the whole squared. It is a plus b plus c the whole squared model. It is x squared plus y squared plus z squared plus 2xy plus 2yz plus 2zx plus c1. Now you can cancel x squared plus y squared plus z squared at the left hand side with the x squared plus y squared plus z squared at the right hand side. It has been underlined by it has been underlined, and therefore c1 is equal to 2xy plus 2yz plus 2zx. Now dividing by 2, we can get a constant c1 dash is equal to xy plus yz plus zx. Therefore we can write u of x comma y comma z is equal to xy plus yz plus zx. Now we have found out only u of xyz, that is u is equal to xy plus yz plus zx. We know that the solution is phi of u comma v is equal to 0. Phi of u comma v is equal to 0. And therefore, let you know one algebra that if 2 by 3 is equal to 4 by 6 is equal to 6 by 9. Now you can easily understand that 2 by 3 is equal to 4 by 6 is equal to 6 by 9. Now 2 minus 4 divided by 3 minus 6 is equal to 4 minus 6 divided by 6 minus 9 is equal to 2 minus 6 divided by 3 minus 9. Check it. And minus 2 by minus 3, minus 2 by minus 3, minus 4 by minus 6 have come. And they will all become 2 by 3 equal to 2 by 3 equal to 2 by 3. Now you have understand an algebra here. Using that algebra to find out v from dx by p equal to dy by q is equal to dz by z. This is written as, that is from dx by x squared minus yz is equal to dy by y squared minus zx is equal to dz by z squared minus xy. We are writing dx minus dy is equal to x squared minus yz minus y squared minus zx is equal to dy by dz, dy minus dz divided by y squared minus zx minus z squared minus xy. This step you have to clearly understand, clearly register in your mind as per the number algebra has been given. Now rewrite the equation from the previous step. It is dx minus dy divided by x squared minus yz minus y squared minus zx is equal to dy minus dz divided by y squared minus zx minus z squared minus xy. Now the numerator can be taken as, at the left hand side, it is d of x minus y. The denominator is, now you group the terms as x squared minus y squared plus other two terms are there, in that minus yz is there plus zx is there, and take z into x minus y. Now go to the right hand side. The numerator can be written as d of y minus z divided by, at the denominator, grouping the terms as y squared minus z squared minus x. You are having minus zx term and plus xy term, plus xy term, and taking term and taking minus x outside, it will become x into y minus z, x into y minus z. This you have to work it on a separate paper and you have to arrive at. And the next step is d of x minus y divided by x squared minus y squared can be written as x plus y into x minus y. The other term has been written as it is, z into x minus y. At the right hand side is equal to, at the right hand side, the numerator is d of y minus z and y squared minus z squared can be written as a plus b into a minus b form. It is y plus z into y minus z. The other term is written as it is. It is x into y minus z. And now the next step is arrived as d of x minus y divided by, look into the denominator, and in the first term at the left hand side, z into x minus y, and the other term x minus y is there. X minus y is commonly taken outside. The remaining terms x plus y plus z is written. And also at the right hand, d of y minus z is written as it is. And looking into the two terms, they are having y minus z as a common term. So y minus z is taken outside, and writing the remaining terms, it will become both sides x plus y plus z at the denominator. We get d of x minus y divided by x minus y is equal to d of y minus z. Taking integrals on both sides, it becomes integral of d of x minus y divided by x minus y is equal to integral of d of y minus z divided by y minus z. Taking integral, it is log of x minus y is equal to log of y minus z is equal to log c2. And moving the log of y minus z to the left hand side, it will become log of x minus y minus log of y minus z is equal to log c2. And the next step is, it can be written as, the left hand side can be written as log of x minus y divided by y minus z is equal to log c2. Cancelling logarithm on both sides, it becomes x minus y divided by y minus z is equal to c2. This can be taken as b of x comma y comma z. The solution is phi of u comma v is equal to 0. And we already know that u is equal to xy plus yz plus zx. Now we know the solution is phi of u comma v equal to 0. Therefore the solution is phi of xy plus yz plus zx comma x minus y divided by y minus z is equal to 0 is the required solution.